got. It's got more. You pause to think, it won't.
What's going on, everyone? Great Talon here, and today the prey is going to be my Remnant from the Ashes initial reaction, my first reaction. I was planning on doing a review on this because I'm hoping to get to the end of the game, but it's just a long, arduous journey to get there, with that being said. And so you know what? Let me just give you my first reaction, because I've been playing a lot of this, and at first I was having a lot of issues, because at first I got it on the PC, having a lot of issues connectivity wise. Then I said, you know what, let me just get it on the PS4. I kind of did a little double dipping, but I said, you know what, I really was enjoying the aesthetic of the game and the lore and the whole structure. The infrastructure was very, very tantalizing, and I was loving it. I said, oh shit, this is great. It's the best. What is this game? As you can see, it's a combination and culmination of The Division, like Tom Clancy, the Division, as well as other games like Diablo, as well as Dark Souls, just kind of fused together. Little intricacies from all those three games just meshed into one. And it's honestly, it's a little janky, yes, but there's been some balancing issues. Like when you first got the game, the game came out, a couple of weeks back, there was a ton of balancing issues where you literally, you couldn't, if you had in a co-op game, because this game is co-op, it's three-player co-op, if you were in a co-op session, even with just one other person, like, you see the amount of damage I'm doing to the boss right now, I was not doing nearly that much damage. We were not, like, the boss was absorbing our shots like he was just a sponge cake, like he was a lofty sponge cake, and we were just like fucking just like dab, like did like touching him, barely touching him. But now they patched and they balanced it after about a week, and it's a lot better now. And I really appreciate for what it is now. The balancing was the biggest problem besides the connectivity on the PC, but the connectivity online, connecting and playing with the buddy, is my own, I think, problem, because I have a router modem issue with my service provider. But that's only on the PC. But the PS4, I was fine with connectivity wise. I was playing like no problem, no disconnects, you know, knock on wood, everything was fine. So this game, it takes place in a post-apocalyptic setting where you play as these like drifter type characters who gets rescued. You know, you're looking for this tower and you get rescued by this this clan, and you start doing missions for them and find out like they're like this ancestors of some, they're descendants of some ancestral type creatures who were part of this world, and they're opening the door between worlds, and you're just like, you know, it's like a whole snowball effect of like, you know, you uncover like conspiracies with prophets and destiny and whatnot, and you're unlocking like Pandora's box almost as you try and unlock the secrets of this world, what happened to it, why it's in ruin. You unlock different worlds, different gateways to other worlds, dimensions, realities, which is nice and pretty cool, if I do say so myself. And like each area, there's several bosses within each area. The first world is very dark and brownish, reddish, like rust, almost called like a rust color. But once you get out of this world that I'm in now, I'm showcasing here, this is like a start of another boss fight, you get out of this world and you go to another world, and it's nice, colorful. It almost reminds me of that movie Dune or Stargate, where it's nice and it's a desert area, but it's nice and orange and lush yellow and vibrant, more vibrant colors, and I'll show you in a minute. But no, I really am enjoying this game, my time with this game. Like I said, the upgrade system, you upgrade your traits, you upgrade your guns, your modifications to your guns. There's no character levels other than trait levels for different like perks, like passive skills. Your guns, you get a ton of different guns and gun mods, where you can modify your guns and add different effects to them. You can add a gun that has fire effects, or you can add a gun that summons familiars. You can add a gun that gives you a healing boost. You can add a gun that has a grenade launcher attachment. The list goes on, and they're all so customizable, and the depth in this game is so rich in its depth and customization, which is great, and that's the draw. It keeps bringing me back. You get to do these like random dungeons, and the whole world is randomized. So every time you load it up, you're getting a different build of the game. Their items are placed differently each playthrough. So, you know, they might, even though like key items might be in the same area, they're not going to be in the same part of the area every time you load the game. You can actually also choose to re-roll the campaign if you want to, re-roll not your character but the campaign. So you can get the whole campaign resets, but your character stays the same level and whatnot, and retains all the gear. And that's pretty cool. I like that. It's like Diablo's type thing, and that's really cool. You know, it's over-the-shoulder gunplay. It's pretty fine. There's no cover system like Gears of War. It's just kind of like dodging, you know, evading like Dark Souls. You know, just dealing a lot of damage to the enemy, like DPS, like damage per second. That's showcased as well. Your healing items, you get Estus Flasks like Dark Souls that are constantly replenished at checkpoints. You can purchase healing items as well as other items like healing, like status effects like rot, bleeding, hazardous waste like radiation and stuff like that and whatnot. It works out pretty well. You can start off the game with three different types of builds. You can start off with a scrapper class, which is what my buddy is right now, like a shotgun based class. You can start off with a duster class like me, which is like you get the repeater rifle, or you can start off with another class. I forget the name of it, but I think it starts off with like an assault rifle or sniper rifle. I think a sniper rifle, because in the game, as you can see right now, I'm using, this is the secondary world of the game, by the way, and you can see the melee weapon I just obtained is awesome. It's a charging, and you get melee weapons too. You start off with a regular hatchet, but I found this in the environment. See, look, it's like Dark Souls. You get fog doors for bosses. It's pretty funny. You know, this melee weapon I have right now is pretty cool. It's a charging melee, like ball and chain type weapon. It's pretty awesome. I really enjoy my time with this game so far. I'm actually going to go play it in a bit. I'm making this video at night, so I'm going to go hop on a little bit, get a little time in with it. And it just gets better as you progress. In the beginning, it feels very rough handled. But as you progress and you understand how to play the game, how it works, you know, you have to just get a little few shots in, duck, dip, dive, dodge, and roll your way to victory. Ammo is replenished, as you can see. You can pick up ammo on the ground, or you can carry ammo boxes with you. You can buy ammo boxes from merchants, too. As you can see, I'm going to use one in a little bit that actually, you know, reload your ammo on the fly in case you're running low. And you carry two weapons at a time. So this is the game pretty much. It's pretty fun. If anybody out there likes The Division or like Diablo or even a little hint of Dark Souls sprinkle on there, it's more so The Division though and Diablo than Dark Souls. It has Dark Souls elements like fog doors and Estus flasks and bosses with big ass health bars. But you don't lose anything upon death. You don't lose souls or your currency, nothing like that. So it encourages you to just keep trying again. The checkpoints are like bonfires, but other than that, the core gameplay is more so like The Division, and the whole level infrastructure is kind of like built up like Diablo. There's dungeons, there's different, pretty much just dungeon areas where you can go to and then clear out and then leave, go back to the main hub, upgrade your gear, go wash, rinse, and repeat, find new areas, and just, you know, you're slowly progressing as time goes on, slowly but surely. And I like that. I think that's pretty awesome. And it's good. It's pretty good. The sound effects are really good. The voice acting is surprisingly well. The developers of this game self-published too, and it's called Gunfire Games. And if you're not familiar with Gunfire Games, what they did in the past was they did Darksiders 3 and a couple of other different games. Oh, and you also get like armor too. I forgot to mention there's armor you can upgrade, and you can get accessories that enhances your perks. I got a couple of rings. You get two ring slots and one necklace slot, amulet slot. They just do passive effects like, you know, reduces your stamina, degeneration, or it reduces your status buildup. increases your reload time, can affect your ability to do damage and stuff like that, and withstand damage, so on and so forth. It's pretty fun, pretty interesting. The depth here is substantial. And if I do say so myself, the game is really fun. If I had a score right now, my initial impression, when I first started the game, I was like, wow, this game is janky as hell. I don't know if I'm going to get into it. And I first started the game, like, first day, 2-3 days with it, I was like, nah, this is a 6. This is a 6 out of 10 all the way. But now that I've gotten about a week plus into it, I'm like, yeah, all right, this game is shaping up to be, I would say, right now, it's an 8. It's an 8 out of 10 for me. I hope it stays that way. I really hope it does. But, you know, only time will tell. But in the meantime, if you guys are interested in this game, it's out for the PC, the PlayStation 4, and the Xbox One at this time. Retailing for $39.95, or $39.99 rather, whatever. And it's not a full price game, and that's what makes it more interesting. And yeah, it's pretty fun. I'm having a ball with it. I'm going to play it right now. So with that being said, thanks for stopping by. Don't forget to drop a like and a comment and a sub below. And I will catch you guys on the next one. You guys have a great day.